Hello, welcome to our DrChrono tutorial. DrChrono has partnered with IronBridge to help connect our primary care and immunizing providers to all state immunization registries with one integration. Through this partnership, our customers will be able to easily and quickly connect to their practice's state registry to submit applied and historical vaccine data, as well as query forecasted and historical immunizations. This video will demonstrate how to enter and submit a vaccine record and sync to the state registry, as well as query forecasted and historical vaccinations and immunizations. Let's begin. Before I demonstrate how to submit a vaccine record, it is important to note that it is required to have data entered in specific fields for patient demographics and the IIS publicity profile in order to successfully send a submission. Blank fields will generate a message in the message center detailing which required fields are missing. Once these fields have been entered, you will not have to do so going forward. For demographics, under the important tab, the required fields are the patient's first name and last name and their telecom information, either home phone, cell phone, office phone, or email address. Under demographics, required fields are patient's date of birth, sex, race, ethnicity, their full mailing address, and if the patient has a responsible party, all required fields are entered. However, either the responsible party phone or responsible party email address will suffice. Both are not required. Moving over to the immunization section, click on the jump to, and then IIS publicity profile. Optional fields are ID number and mother's maiden name. The remaining fields are required. Now that we have those required fields entered for demographics and IIS publicity profile, let's move forward with entering a vaccine record and syncing to the state registry. You have the option to send an individual record to the state registry or group submission. Just simply select your vaccine. And choose the option to select the bottom. You'll have your VIS or vaccine information statement screen here to review with the patient. And as you can see, there is a counter here that shows which vaccines will be sent as a group. For this example, we will just send one individual vaccine. So I'll just come back through here and then choose the red X to remove. So let's just choose this particular vaccine and select at the bottom right corner. Here, there are no vaccine information statements to review, so I can skip. And below, I'll enter in all the required sections, beginning with current status, once the record type is selected, required fields will appear as a red asterisk. I'll have the option to save and sync to registry or simply save locally to DrChrono's platform. Once I choose the option, coming back to step one, I can then look at the registry sync column to see the status of that vaccination. So here it was successfully sent to the registry. Here there was an error when sending, so it saved it locally instead. And then here I chose to save this particular vaccine locally. You also have the option to click on the indicator here to sync this vaccine to the state registry. If an error occurs, you can visit the message center to view the details of that error. On to the next workflow to be able to query the history and forecasted vaccines for the patient. Simply click on the History and Forecast button under the Step 1 section. Choose the Primary Requesting Office. Here we can see all of the recorded vaccines that are scheduled or forecasted and all historical. There is also an option to reconcile historical vaccines from the state registry to DrChrono by simply clicking the state recorded historical vaccines and simply clicking on reconcile. Once the historical immunizations have been reconciled, you'll have the option to then choose the proper schedule for that patient, if that has not already been chosen in the past, and also see those that have been reconciled. This concludes demonstrating how to enter and submit a vaccination record, as well as query for forecasted and historical vaccinations and immunizations. I hope that this video was helpful. You can also review our existing knowledge base articles or contact our support team at drchrono.com.